another session at the breakout with these guys, Donovan and Jared from Brewster Academy. They just played, what game is this? Third game today?
Third game today, yeah.
How was it? Well, I saw it, so you don't have to tell me.
It went well at the beginning. We just, you could tell everyone was tired. Both teams were just kind of physically tired, and we just didn't get stopped at the end and kind of gave up the lead. I think this kid played a hell of a game trying to guard a Scal, who had been lighting everyone up and held them 2 points today. So without that effort, I don't think the game would have been as close.
By the way, I saw you did that 360 pump fake and a layup. That was not in this game, the game previous. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. That was a heck of a move.
Thank you. So
how has it been here so far at the Reebok Breakout Camp overall?
It's been great, especially for me. I got three offers after my first game today. So Louisville, Memphis, and University of South Florida.
Wow.
So it's been great for me, and a lot of people are starting to see my game, because before I didn't really have as much exposure as playing in the Under Armour circuit. I didn't play. We didn't play up, so we were playing our age, and all the coaches would leave after the older kids had played. So
yeah,
this probably, I would say, the biggest event for me this summer.
Okay.
And I think I've been doing pretty well so far.
What about you, Jarrett?
Yeah, it's been a good event. I mean, it's fun too. We have a really good team. Today was our first loss, and we shouldn't have lost, but we have. It's fun. We won all our games. We've all played pretty well, and I mean, there's a ton of coaches, so it's great to win and look good in front of the coaches.
Yeah. Now you got how many done for tonight?
Yeah,
that's it, right? Bedtime.
Sleep.
Get some rest. Tomorrow you got a few more games to go.
Two more.
And then how? 1 to 10. Not tired. Tired.
Tired is 10, is that what you said?
How about your knees right now, your old man knees?
I've been playing as hard as I've ever played in my entire life, so it's kind of different, but it's great. So okay. I feel like I can go tomorrow and be fine.
Yeah, a little banged up just playing 3 games, just more opportunities to get hit and stuff, but I feel good too, I can go again.
Okay, you're going to be here for the weekend tournament.
Yeah, I'm going to Springfield.
You're going to Springfield?
Yeah.
Okay. Now let's talk about your summer overall thus far. You're with the city and you're with the New England players. How have they been?
Well, I haven't played with the city as much as he's played with the players. I played with them for, say, going to be my third tournament this weekend. And we've been doing real well. I mean, we won our first tournament two weekends ago. So we've been just trying to get a feel for each other because everyone else left because they're all older and graduated to go to college.
Right.
So it's kind of get a feel for the new team. And I think that this upcoming weekend in this July, we should be perfectly fine. We should enjoy a good summer.
We've had a good spring, but kind of a struggle. We lost some guys. We had a good roster coming in.
Yeah.
Lost some guys. Rebuilt our roster. Played a few tournaments. We were playing well. And now two of our guards are hurt. So kind of going into July, we just throwing a team together a little bit, so we're.
I want to ask you guys about some of the recruiting situations up right now for both of you guys. You got 3 new offers, and you still have a good amount of schools, quite a few as well. Can we talk a little bit about them?
As far as
visits, which schools are the strongest coming after you guys? Whatever you feel comfortable talking about.
Well, for me, I actually visited Georgia Tech, Florida State, and those are two I visited this past summer, over this summer so far. I plan to visit a few more, like Louisville and Indiana and other schools on my officials. But the recruiting, as far as strongest, I would say the schools that have offered me all those schools have been talking to me the most, calling me the most, just so they can show their interest in me. And then, like I said, with Louisville, they just offered me today, but I've been in contact with them for a long time. And on top of that, I've been in contact with Coach Johnson before that, so he knew my game before he even got to Louisville. So
right, he's from Indiana, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he left Indiana to go to Louisville, so I've been in contact with them for a while.
What about you, Jared?
I still have a good amount of schools recruiting me, and still some new schools coming into the mix, like even this week. So I don't know. I have a lot to think about before August.
Both of you guys are going to do it before the end of 2014, like early season or next year?
Yeah, I don't have any, like, I don't have like a date set or a time period set where I want to commit, but I know I'm far from making a decision right now, so I'm trying to have the idea of making a list or 5 to 7 school lists sometime in August so I can figure out my official visits and all that in the fall.
Do you have any strong schools like that are really pursuing you, calling you more than the other schools?
Providence, URI, South Carolina, Northwestern. I'm missing a lot, but there are a few schools that are recruiting pretty hard.
Now, for both of you guys, is it, you guys are both Northeast guys.
Yeah.
Well, you want to play close to home, where your parents see you often, or it does, that's not...
I mean, it'd be great to find a place where your parents and family and everyone can see you play, but I think it's more important to find the right fit wherever it may be.
Definitely. I mean, going to boarding school both for both of us, it helps us learn to be away from home. Because there are other guys who go to public school their entire life and don't know how to be away from home. So when they go to school and they have one struggle, maybe it's on the court, and they're used to going back to their parents, but they can't because they're so far away. So I feel like boarding school has helped Jared and I being able to like kind of be more mature than others to go out and realize we don't have to be close to home. We kind of want the right fit, and we can go to Iowa or like a school like that far away from home because we're Northeast guys, or on the West Coast because we've been used to being away from home.
Right, you guys, I mean, New England school guys are usually pretty good.
Yeah.
Especially in this past draft.
Mm-hmm.
They all came out. There's a couple of guys from Brewster.
Yeah, I think three. Yeah.
Have you seen them recently?
I have not, actually.
No, there's no alumni game this year. They're all getting ready for the draft.
Wow, that's a first.
Yeah.
That's a first. Now, let's segue into Brewster next year. Final year for both of you guys. Enjoyable. You guys weren't there for 4 years. I mean, most of the guys are not there for four years, but you came in last year, and
same.
So did you.
Yeah.
So you guys playing 2 years over at Brewster, which is a really great experience in AAA.
Yeah.
What are you looking forward for both of you guys to do and accomplish for this coming season?
First off, I would say win both again.
Yeah. Win both.
Kind of be the first team to do
good luck, my friend.
Kind of be the first team to do that, to win both.
And just
helping each other get better for next year, for the year after this upcoming year for college. Just being able, whether it's the games or it's after the season, just helping each other and helping us compete. Because I know the guys that graduated this year, all they were doing was just kind of showing us what we needed to do to get ready for college. So having 2 years of that is going to be great for us.
We both started this year, all year, so... I mean, it's a good foundation for next year's team, and I think we have like a good understanding of what we need to do and how we need to help guys. So, I mean, we have a head start going into the season with everybody.
How many of the, I mean, besides you two that are returning top guys?
Just us.
Just you two right now. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. You're a little Miami Heat right now. You know, Jason's got to get on the phone and get the LeBrons to come on with you guys. So it's just you two right now?
Yeah.
Sam.
I need to call him
Sam,
up.
Sam.
And who?
Sam. He's Sam Kiley. He plays on both the varsity B team and the varsity A team.
Okay, yeah.
He's always been there. His dad works for the school. He's a great kid, too.
Wow. So it's three of you.
Yeah.
That's it. Okay, so there's a lot of open shots. I'm going to see like 30 shots on your stats. 30 shots on your stats.
Probably not.
30
probably
shots
not
on his stats. Is there anything in your game that you guys want to work on that you know deep down inside, man, I got to improve on this?
Shooting and dribbling. I mean, if I want to be a point guard in college, if I stay this height, I'm going to have to be a point guard. I can't be going against 6'8", two guards every night and be expecting to like succeed or having as much success as I would as playing the point. So being able to kind of running the team from my hands, and then just being able to dribble and shoot. And I feel like I've been shooting very well, but dribbling I have to kind of work on a little bit more, I think.
Okay, what about you?
I mean, I want to get better at all aspects. I feel like I have like a lot of work to do, but I really need to just become more athletic, better rebounder, and just be a more active big man, because I know that's what I lack and kind of my fault in my game. I just need to be a lot more athletic.
Do you feel, who do you guys feel over here gave you guys some like challenge that you feel like, I want to put it in the right way. You know, when you come here, some of these guys you've never seen here, you've never seen them before. You might have heard of them.
Yeah.
You might never seen them until the first time you step onto the court. Is there anybody from the first day and today so far, the games that you felt like, I'm pretty impressed?
I think our own teammate,
Justin
has been really, really good.
Came in and we had heard about him. We heard he was on the team, and we didn't know who he was really. And then after, I would say, our first game,
and
after our first scrimmage, even he was
really
flying.
Impressed.
He was laying the ball. I mean, I was in the guard drill, so I got to see him before he really did, and I saw that he was making plays, and it was just like, wow. It was
good
plays that you wouldn't even see coming, and he would just make that play. It's definitely him.
Derek.
And then Derek Jones, of course.
Oh, yeah.
I saw him play at the Mary Klein game a few months ago, and we won MVP, but I knew he could jump, but this past week, he's just been, I think he's got a little higher.
He's athletic.
Okay, yeah. I saw a little bit of that today, too.
Just a little bit.
So but you guys did your thing as well. That's kind of interesting. These are some of the names you guys are throwing out. I also want to ask you guys, there's some other questions I want to ask you guys. You guys met earlier in the day. Day one, there was a couple of players coming in. Shaq,
yeah.
Dominique, Gerald Green. Is there anything that you heard from them when they were talking that you learned?
I mean, for me, just seeing them is kind of like, I mean, just being at the camp, first of all, is kind of like a big thing, especially for me coming from not being known. I mean, for both of us, actually, not being known at all to being here, listening to those guys talk about how they were at this camp, how they were, well, some guys were unknown, and then come out to be, well, Shaq's about to be a billionaire and stuff like that. So it's kind of crazy and surreal, to be honest. And it's not as much as what they said. It's just the fact that, like, knowing that they're here watching you as long as well as the big head coaches that you see on TV every day, see on TV growing up as a kid. It's kind of like put it in all in perspective, I guess.
Let me ask you: Do you guys ever get nervous, like when you see this much coaches, like?
No, I think you get nervous, but I think you got
to
kind of.
Is there pressure like to perform or?
You got to get rid of it. Like, you get nervous initially, but you got to get rid of it because, you know, it's a huge opportunity and we get, 16 minutes to play. So you got to put being nervous aside and just go do what you can do. So
the first night, we both walked in and we were like, whoa.
Getting the jitters before we walked in.
It was wild, right?
An hour before our game. And I would say 15 minutes in, it was like, okay.
Forgot about it.
Right, ready to play. Yeah. So. I mean, it's going to be that way in college. We're not going to have to. It's going to be 16,000 people who, when you do something great, they cheer. When you do something bad, they're going to start cursing you out, whatever it may be, from the stands. And then when you play in the road, it's even worse. So this, is nothing for now compared to what we're going to go up against.
You guys been to a lot of visits, I could tell. I'm sure. I know you've been to visit. Which school have you visited so far?
Over the course of 4 years of high school, I've been to Providence, URI most recently, Boston College, and UConn, just the local schools. But I haven't really taken any trips out of New England for any visits.
Okay. Well, I mean, that's going to happen soon.
Yeah.
Before the season starts, you know.
For sure.
Because it gets busier and whatnot. Now, next week, I think your team is also going to Georgia, right? And your team is going to Georgia, obviously. You guys are in kind of like a different bracket, but same tournament. Mm-hmm. You're going to be at the Under Armour thing as well.
Yeah.
I saw on the schedule, so I figure, looking forward to that, both of you guys.
Yeah. Another good opportunity.
Hasta luego. Yeah. See you later. No more high school AU.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy to think about, but I think we're both really focused on this, which sets up kind of Georgia, if that makes sense. So as far as coaches are concerned, so
yeah, you got to finish this week first.
This week has to be. You can't be looking for, oh, I'll just play better in front of this coach in Georgia. It's kind of do your thing now. that way when you get to Georgia, you don't have to worry as much. It's kind of like that.
Yeah.
But as far as the competition, I think we're both ready to play, just ready to, I mean, it's great being on a team with a bunch of stars, but I think it's great that we get to do our own thing.
Yep.
It's always great to do our own thing, and him and I are both kind of the leaders on our team, so I feel like that'll be great.
In the next 5 years, right, 5 years, so minus one because you're still in Brewster, right? Yeah. So where do you guys see yourself?
I see myself playing basketball, making money playing basketball. I don't know if it's going to be in the NBA or overseas, but I feel like just being able to provide for my family after basketball.
Gone to a good school, had a good career, college career, was productive, won all 4 years, got a degree, and was doing what we can do, playing if we could.
I think we had a great interview. Yeah. Thank you very much, Donovan.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jared. Mm-hmm. Good luck the rest of the way, and I'll see you guys soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.